How long have you been living in New York City?
I don't really live here, but I've been sort of coming back and forth for about 6 years.
What's your favorite place to hang out in New York City?
Central Park.
What's the coolest thing about New York City?
That you can order pancakes and breakfast any time, day or night.
You know him as the star of a Harry Potter film series, a franchise that has smashed box office records and stands as the third highest growing film franchise of all time. With 8 films grossing over $7.7 billion worldwide, Harry Potter himself, AKA Daniel Radcliffe. With an estimated net worth of $110 million, with the bulk having been earned prior to his 21st birthday, the young superstar has been able to afford himself quite the impressive real estate portfolio. With pads all over New York City, and if you want to see what it's like to live in these shoes, we even found one condo of his you could rent for just $19,000 a month.
When I first came to New York, you know, I wanted to do all the tourist stuff and go to Statue of Liberty and Empire State Building and all that stuff. But, like, the real joy of getting to live in New York has become, like, I don't know, just, like, the neighborhoody stuff and, like, diners.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy Marlon Palmer, and excited to be back here on Famous Entertainment. We're going to be looking at Daniel Radcliffe and the properties he calls home, splitting his time between Fulham, London, and his home in West Village of Lower Manhattan in New York. And we even found some of the listings. If you like this video, make sure you're subscribed and ring that bell to be notified when we post, so you can always be up to date. We've also done house tours on the likes of Arnold Schwarzenegger and Jerry Seinfeld. Follow me on Instagram, ThatDudeMcFly. We could chat some more. Let me know whose house tour is next in the comments below. Now let's get into the video. Radcliffe has stated he knew he wanted to be an actor by the age of 5, and he scored his first acting role in 1999 when he was just 10 years old. He played a young David Copperfield in BBC One's 2-part television adaptation of Charles Dickens' novel of the same name. Crazy to think that while Daniel made his acting debut at age 10, his huge break would come just 2 years in. In 2000, Radcliffe was invited to audition for the title role in the first Harry Potter film, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, or The Sorcerer's Stone for those in the US. After a number of callbacks, auditions and an 8-month wait, he was offered the role. It would become the breakout role that brought him his $110 million net worth and international fame and wealth. The first Harry Potter film was released in 2001, and Daniel reportedly received a paycheck of $1 million. Not bad for a 12-year-old boy. Now, the second film of the series, Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, was released a year later and also crushed the box office. It also earned Radcliffe a fee of $3 million. Although these paychecks seem pretty high to most of us, they're chopped liver compared to the paychecks Radcliffe would command for the remaining movies of that series. Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban released in 2004 and earned Radcliffe a payday of $6 million. He went on to make $11 million for Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire and $14 million for Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix released in 2005 and 2007. The sixth movie, Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, reportedly brought Daniel another $24 million. The last book of the series was split into 2 films, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 1 and Part 2 released in 2011. Radcliffe's combined earnings from both movies were $50 million. As the series continued to blow up in popularity internationally, Daniel Radcliffe and his co-stars became international celebrities. At age 16, Radcliffe became the youngest non-royal to have his portrait hung in the National Portrait Gallery. In 2006, Radcliffe and his 2 main co-stars, Emma Watson and Rupert Grint, were invited to leave imprints of their hands, feet, and wands outside of Grauman's Chinese Theater in Hollywood. Reviews of the film were generally favorable, and the series became the highest grossing film franchise ever, right after the Marvel Cinematic Universe movies and Star Wars. Now, to recap, Daniel Radcliffe's Harry Potter salary and earnings in total, between base salaries, profit participation, ongoing royalties, and other sources of income, Daniel Radcliffe has earned at least $100 million from the franchise. Although he made a small fortune from the Harry Potter films, Radcliffe claims he has hardly touched the money. He considers himself lucky that he ever has to worry about finances and can be selective about the projects that he chooses to work on, and plans to do some directing and producing in the future. He splits his time between Fulham, London, and his home in the West Village of Lower Manhattan in New York, which finally brings us to his house tour.
You do have a home here, right?
Yeah.
You have a home in this city. What do you do? Where would we see you roaming around? What would you be
doing? I don't
know
if I should say that. I'm telling you.
Yeah, tell us exactly.
At an early age, Radcliffe reportedly decided to focus his real estate investments on the NYC market, which may be why he sold his 3-bedroom penthouse in the prosperous Toorak area of Melbourne, Australia. His parents originally bought this property and then signed it over to him when he came of age. That being said, Radcliffe likely also owned some property in England, where he was born and raised. However, his childhood home in fashionable West London, where he lived from 3 to 12, was sold in 2016. Over the years, he snagged some luxurious homes in New York City. In October 2009, Curb New York reported that the actor had picked up a house in the West Village for $5.65 million at the time. He had already been spreading his real estate seed all over downtown Manhattan for years. The story notes that he previously snagged a $4.3 million condo in Soho and later added an equally expensive three-bedroom pad in the West Village's 1 Morton Square. His West Village acquisition is an 18-foot-wide townhouse that a Sotheby's listing explained is located on one of New York's most picturesque tree-lined landmark cobblestone blocks and is one of three adjoining homes built by a sea captain in 1847 for three of his daughters. In addition to three floors that include a living room, dining room, kitchen, powder room, four bedrooms, three baths, a balcony overlooking the garden, and six working fireplaces. There's also a separate one-bedroom apartment with a wood-burning fireplace and a picture window facing the garden. The listing happened to note that the separate apartment could be rented out, which is exactly what Radcliffe did with another one of his NYC homes. Daniel Radcliffe may not have Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry privileges, but he has been known to let you stay in one of his stunning New York City homes, that is, if you're willing to cough up $19,000 per month. According to Variety, that's how much the Harry Potter actor was renting in Soho condo for in 2015. All things considered, that's actually a relatively good price considering it cost the Harry Potter star over $4 million to purchase the fabulous residence. So what will that kind of cash get you? The home is 1,843 square feet and features two bedrooms and 2.5 bathrooms. There's also a relatively compact, if stylishly sleek and expensively equipped gallery-style kitchen that sits between two distinct but integrated areas, an essentially windowless dining area just inside the front door, and a living room with a sunny south-facing floor-to-ceiling wall of windows and a huge sliding panel-mounted with floating bookshelves that slides open to reveal a library guest bedroom with an ensuite bathroom. When you'd like a little privacy, residents can relax in the master bedroom, which boasts a roomy walk-in closet, or they can get cozy in the marble-floored master bathroom that contains a super-sized soaking tub. The building itself offers a full staff, fitness center, swimming pool, and a garage, which is definitely prime real estate in downtown New York City. Considering the fact that Daniel owns multiple properties in New York, it's safe to say that he will always have somewhere to stay in the city. Along with the NYC pads we already mentioned, the performer apparently owns another home that Variety describes as a massive luxury complex along the West Side Highway. Paying almost $5 million for the condo in 2008, it's even bigger than his other condos, stretching across 2,446 square feet, featuring three bedrooms and a 3.5 bathrooms. The home also offers the star free views of the Hudson River. All right, so I think I'll bring the house tour to an end here, but be sure to let me know what you guys thought about Harry Potter's homes in the comments down below. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at ThatDudeMcFly, and let me know whose house tour you want to see next. I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.